favorite music, watching the lush green fields. I was cruising at a speed of 260 kilometers per hour when an elderly gentleman walked up to me and gestured me to reduce the volume of the music. I just checked my phone. Is it in speaker mode? No, it was not. Fellow Toastmasters, Mr. Toastmaster, and dear guests, you heard it right. 260 kilometers per hour. I was traveling in a bullet train from Osaka to Tokyo. And this TC walked up to me and he thought the sound which was leaking out of the earphones is perhaps troubling my fellow, my neighbor, fellow passenger. Immediately my mind raced back to work, where on a typical day, within half an hour, I know what my colleague had for breakfast. I know what my other friend, how he fought with his wife and why she was unhappy that night, because he didn't bring the groceries. Not that I'm eavesdropping on them. It's because they're yelling so loud in their cell phones. Toastmasters, in a country technologically so advanced like Japan, where they're obsessed with quality, they still value some basic stuffs, fundamentals. And the country to which I belong, where we touch the feet of elders, take their blessings, pray every god on the road to work. Why? Why is that? We forget to remember that there is someone besides us always. We are disturbing him so much. Why don't we take care of them? In Japan, they call the bullet train as Shinkansen. So it took 2.5 hours for me to reach Tokyo. It's around 600 kilometers. I went to the hotel, it's on 27th floor, and I observed something very unusual. When I was getting into the lift, when there is a crowd, automatically a queue is to get formed. That's in contrast to what happens here, right? All the people, it's chaos. Well, it's not because of those villagers or those illiterate people. Every time I go to my kid's school for a parent's meeting, I see this. When I stand in the queue, their parent just barging in. All they are worried is, my son or daughter should take 95% marks. That's it. Is that what education is all about? Is this how we teach values to our children? Is marks the only thing which makes a difference? Well, again, back to Tokyo. That evening, I thought I'd take a stroll in the crowded street. I grabbed a McDonald's burger and just walking along, and wanted to throw those garbages. But surprisingly, I couldn't find a single dustbin in Tokyo downtown. I walked back with that till the hotel. Immediately I remembered, in India I always keep complaining, there's no dustbin, that's the reason our city is so untidy. Right? But the truth is, when I researched a bit in the net, I found that in Japan there are no dustbins. They carry their garbage back home. Simple things, right? These are the differentiators, my friend. Again, I'm not complaining that actually we don't have this culture. It is always there in us. Our elders have taught us to be clean. Inside the room, you are very clean. Fold your shirts and keep it nicely. Entering your house, remove your chappals. But once you're getting out of the gate, sweep there, do whatever you want. Just extend the boundaries. We are silent in the prayer room. We are silent everywhere. You get out of the gate, sit in the driver's seat, start honking. Man, why do we do this? In the city of Tokyo at 10:30 p.m., when I see a pedestrian waiting for that green light to be turned on, I just think to myself, it's not because they do it because someone has told them to do it. It's because they value it the most. I think this is something which we can all tell our children. Right? It's not that telling them what to do. We should lead by example. That makes a big difference, my dear friends. So these are some simple things which I and you can implement. So today, probably after leaving this hall, there are two things which I request you to do. One, avoid throwing those either cigarette butts or that chocolate wrappers just out of the car window or anywhere. Please do not do that. Second thing, don't step onto your car or actually negative the bike and start honking, or don't use it as a musical instrument unless it is absolutely necessary. Because that's for a reason actually the honkies are there. My dear friends, always the question comes to my mind, We are living in such a fast-paced life. Why should I care about all those things? I got so many things to do. Can a single person make a difference? For me, inspiration is from this man named Nelson Mandela, who spent 27 years in Robben Island prison. He comes out of the prison, becomes the president of South Africa, and he forgives the people who were the reason for his imprisonment, the white people. Right? When he was interviewed once, they asked him, "What is that kept you going?" He said, "There are occasions or many times I felt like I'd have to give up. I felt like lying down. But there's this one poem which I read over and over again." And there's a famous movie about this poem. I think many of you would have seen it. If not, you should watch it. It's called Invictus. The poem written by William Ernst White. I don't want to repeat the entire poem, but the last two lines of the poem says, "I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul." Well, Toastmasters, if you believe or if you want to make a difference, it's all in your hands. If you believe, you can do it. All you.